If you don't want to fall in love with an ugly person, do not hang around ugly people. That is just the truth. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adeze and I'm a YouTuber based in Port Harcourt, Nigeria. So if you're new to my channel, you're welcome. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. You guys, someone's always commenting about how I'm always doing like this. See, I'm used to explaining with my hands. So yeah, just get used to it. I'm always being very theatrical with my hands and all that. Anyway, so in today's video, this is going to be a fun video. So if you're the kind of person that you easily get offended, please quickly go and take your paracetamol or your panadol in advance, because some things I say here might be offensive to you, and you know, I'm sorry about it in advance, but I have to say what I have to say, okay? So yeah, in today's video, I'm going to be talking about things I did to get myself a good man, okay? I feel very awkward saying this, like, oh, you might have a good man. I didn't say he's perfect. I did not say I got myself the perfect man. I got myself a good man, you know? Men don't know that women to do the chasing somehow. In your minds, people think you're the ones that found her. No, she agreed, she allowed you to find her, okay? She knew before you even knew that, okay, this person is someone I can marry. But anyway, so things I did to get myself a good man. See, strive to get yourself a good man. As far as I'm concerned, a good man trumps a perfect man. Perfect people, seemingly perfect men, always have skeletons in their closet that are like conch skeletons, okay? Serious skeletons in their closet, okay? So get yourself a good man. So if you're a kind of person that you are interested in getting a good relationship, you're interested in getting married, you know, it's 2020, your thoughts are on relationships and marriage, then some things I say here would actually be beneficial to you. But if you're not interested, then maybe just click out and we'll talk about something else in another video, okay? So don't come to my comment section and tell me, okay, so I don't really have so many people who come to my comment section to do that, okay? Let me just be honest. But yeah, I love all of you, and let's just jump right into this video. Okay, so one of the first things that I feel, funny enough, people don't really ask me how I met my husband, which is strange. Maybe because me and him don't do videos together. Many people don't really ask me how I met my husband, but you guys, I met my husband on social media, okay? Yes. 2010 was the year I met my husband, and we met on social media. But that is an entire story time on its own. If you guys don't know, we've been married for 8 years, right? Yes, 8 years. So we got married in 2011. Left to him, we would have gotten married in 2010. But nah, I was like, what? But anyway, yeah. So this is my first point, actually relates so much to that. So the point is, put your best foot forward, okay? Not just on social media, not just on, you know, not just outside, but wherever you go. Which, basically, what I'm trying to say is be a good person, okay? You cannot be saying you want a good man, you want a man who does this, you don't want a man who does that. Meanwhile, you are a terrible human being, okay? Tell yourself the truth, have that moment of truth with yourself, sit down and work on your self-awareness, okay? Tell yourself the truth, am I a good person? Do I deserve a good person? Am I a good person spec? Okay, so work on yourself first of all. And like I said about your personality outside, if you are that kind of person, you're always on Insta blog Niger, when they say bass, you say boss. You're just online giving everybody bass, boss, bass, boss. If you're that kind of person, 2020 is the time for you to stop it, okay? You don't know who is watching. Not only God that is watching you, your husband might be watching you, good men might be watching you, good employers might be watching you, good friends might be watching you, good people that can help your life might be watching you, okay? So don't just go online. Like, I'm not saying that it's bad to be savage online. Yes, sometimes that people will say some kind of stupid things and they deserve to get stupid responses in return, okay? But I'm saying unnecessary savageness, which is what I notice online a lot these days. Like, nobody wants to be nice anymore, nobody wants to be pleasant anymore, everybody wants to trend. You want your own, you want the most likes with your response, and sadly, but the most likes go to usually the most, you know, savage responses, okay? So many people want to trend, many people want to be like, they are the ones that can give it to them hot. They're giving it to them hot, acidity hot, no leave, no transfer. So if you notice, this topic is not how to get yourself a man. It is how to get yourself a good man. Because as far as I'm concerned, getting yourself a man is very simple. It is very easy to get yourself a man because men are very cheap. That's just the truth. Men are very cheap. Men are way, way cheaper than women, in case you don't know. Okay, so getting yourself a man is not the issue. Getting yourself a good man is the issue. Ask yourself, this kind of personality I have online, will it attract good men? Will good men like this kind of thing that I'm posting online? This kind of pictures I'm posting online, this kind of, you know, personality I'm portraying online. Some people, which is even sad, your personality online is different from the person you are in real life, which is really, really sad. That's for the bad. Like, your personality online is very bad, but in real life you're just an okay person. It's not like I mean you can't be good in real life and have a bad personality online, okay? But what I'm saying is that you're okay in real life, but because you are behind the keyboard, you want to be what you're not. It's really sad because you are blocking your blessings by likes. Sometimes you don't even get the likes, okay? So anyway, all I am trying to say is be careful the kind of things you post online, be careful the kind of things you say online, careful the kind of things you do outside when you think nobody around. Like sometimes you might feel, who is looking at me here? Nobody's looking at me here. Trust me, somebody's looking at you. It might even be the good man's sister. Yes, it might be the good man's sister that is there, that if you were better, she would have hooked you up with her brother, but no, you decided to be basbozing up and down and you put everybody off. Let me not drag that one too much, but yeah, work on yourself, be a good person. Work on yourself first of all, so you don't have to pretend to be a good person, because trust me, you can't pretend forever. If you're not a good person, it's going to show. Even if you pretend to get the man, once people start, you know, dating and relating, the guy just realized that, sis, you're not what I wanted, you're not what I want. So anyway, so the next point is keep your options open. Yes, keep your options open. Some of you have not yet. See, I did not post anything about my husband until after we got married. Yes, after our wedding, that's why I started posting his pictures. I am not saying that you should not, you know, show off your boo, you should not, but if you know that you and your boo's relationship is rocky, please do not go ahead to start pasting his picture online. Like me, it wasn't like my relationship with him was rocky at all. It wasn't like I knew I was going to marry him. Like, well, not really, not from the start, but at some point I knew I was going to marry him. But even when I knew that there was no going back, I still did not post his picture online. Why? I don't want to use my hand and block my destiny, okay? You don't know. I know it sounds funny, but yeah, you don't know whether it will work out or not, especially when you're not yet gotten married. Like I said, as far as I'm concerned, you are single until you are married. You are single until what? You are married. So if you're a kind of person that just because you are dating, you have branded yourself with the guy, his name is written on your forehead, anywhere you are, he's with you, any pictures you post online, he's there, you are just chasing everybody. Meanwhile, he has not yet even proposed. My sister, you are making a big mistake, okay? Keep your options open until you get married, until you've done your trad, you've done something, you've done intro, you've done trad, then that's when you can start showing off. For me, that's my own opinion, Sha. That's when you can start showing off yourself, because anything can happen. Okay, yeah, so moving on. So the third point I'd like to make is this. Keep it 100, keep it real. Some of you, once man shows up, you become fake. Your accent changes, your behavior changes. If you used to walk like this before, now you start walking like this. Why? That is, I don't get it. If your plan is to end up with this person for the rest of your life, then you better start now to be yourself, because you cannot pretend forever. Okay, that I said, first of all, be a good person. Okay, so that one is one part. So if you're a good person, you don't even need to pretend. Okay, but even when you're a good person, if you're a kind of person that your personality shifts in moments, the moment you see a guy, or you start trying to, a lot of women that change to become who they think the guy wants, okay? A lot of women think, oh, this guy, I think, why are you even thinking for men in the first place, okay? But some women will just see a guy, maybe because of the way he looks, the way he acts, the way he talks, you feel, this guy will not like me, or let me transform myself to someone else so that he will ask me out. See, you are just setting yourself up for failure, because if truly you are not the kind of lady that guy likes, he is going to find out eventually. Like I said, you can't pretend forever. He's going to find out eventually. So save yourself and him the stress and just be yourself. If it is you that he really likes, if it's your personality that he really likes, then he will come for you and you'll be happy, okay? But I'm saying this because I know a lot of women who change their personalities to fit, you know, they're like chameleons. If they date 10 different men, they're going to have 10 different personalities. No, be yourself. Like me, I've never been a pretender. I don't know how to I don't know how to form. Let me put it that way, okay? I don't know how to form. What you see is what you get. So right from the start, I was myself. Even with all the relationships I've had anyway, I've always been myself from the beginning to the end. What you see is what you get. I speak the way I speak. I behave the way I behave. If you like it, fine. If you don't like it, go on. And again, one thing is, if you're even switching your personality to match his own, how do you know that he wants someone who is like him? How do you know? Because he likes Arsenal, you too. You now turn to an Arsenal fan. Meanwhile, you don't even know anything about football. Maybe he doesn't want an Arsenal fan. He's okay with his male friends that are Arsenal fans, okay? So I'm just trying to say that you don't need to change your personality or, you know, change yourself to suit what he wants. Just be yourself, and the person who wants you is going to find you. That's just the truth. Yeah, so the fourth point, and this point is actually one of the most important points, okay? And that is, have standards, okay? Have quality standards. I'm not saying you should have extremely high standards, but sis, please have standards. Why are you taking every Tom, Dick and Harry? Every Tom, Dick and Harry you are accepting just because you want a boo. I don't understand. Valentine's Day is coming. Oh, because of Valentine, I need a boo. Anything that comes your way, you will now collect. Why? Have a standard. It's something that my father did for me, and to me, that's even one of the biggest reasons why I was successful in getting a good man. Okay, when I was younger, I think I was like 19 or something. Yeah, I was about 19 years or so, or 17 or 18. I don't know. My dad called me one day. I'm sure he noticed that, okay, this guy is beginning to lecha yari. You know, they call it lecha when you start, when you're just, you know, as a young girl, now when you start realizing, oh, I'm actually a pretty person, guys actually like me, you know, I'm actually attracting the opposite sex. You know, that age now when you're like, ah, oh, I'm too much, you know, boobs and as I said coming out, you know, you're not like, you're not feeling like a woman. Mm-hmm. My father called me and said, nay. Yeah, so he called me and he now said that he would like to know the kind of guy that I want to marry. Okay, that I should tell him the kind of guy I want to marry. Imagine at that age, that kind of conversation with your father. Nope. We've never had that kind of conversation in the past, so it was so cringy to me when he called me and told me that I should sit down and tell him the kind of guy that I want to marry. You know, so as per good girl that I am now, I was not saying things like, which are actually part of my list. I always had a list mentally, sure. But yeah, I was saying things like, I want him to be God-fearing, I want him to be hardworking, I want him to be intelligent, I want him to love me, I want him to be respectful, you know, I want him to be active in church. Those are the kind of things I was saying. You know, my Mwachukwu. So my dad now said, okay, that's good, that's very good. But you not told me about how you want him to look. You not told me his physical, not said anything about his physical appearance. I was like, oh no, don't ask me. I was just like, oh my God, this man should not ask me this kind of, I don't want to say it, you know, because I was shy. I was just like, ugh. Why would I tell my father the kind of man I want to marry, as in the physical attributes were just so, blah. But anyway, I had to tell him, and I told him I wanted a guy who is taller than me. I don't care about complexion, but I don't want somebody who is too dark or too fair. To be honest, I said all these things, so I don't want anybody that is too dark or too fair. I want him to be handsome, but even as I was saying it, I was like, nah. But anyway, after that whole discussion with my father, it forced me to actually sit down and tell myself what I wanted, okay? Because my father told me, tell me what you want so that you pray about it and I'll pray about it with you, okay? So it is very important for you to pray about the kind of man you want. God will grant you your heart desires. He will grant you your heart desires. He's not going to give you what you cannot handle or what does not suit you or what you hate, okay? So, like I said, I prayed about it. It made me sit down, think, and, you know, really think and really articulate what I wanted. And thankfully, I wasn't superficial. I wanted a man who was God-fearing, who was devoted to God, who was family-oriented, who loved me, who loved his family, who, you know, things like that. So all I'm trying to say is that have standards. Not everybody that comes your way is who you should accept. Yourself, you are the woman. You are the one that should be wooed. You are the one that should do the selecting. When they come, do the selecting. Choose. Don't be there and be waiting to be chosen and be like, oh, pick me. No, don't be a pick me, okay? So yeah, have standards, and the right man, trust me, if you have good standards, good man will be attracted to you, okay? The right man will be attracted to the right standards. But if your standards are very low, even no nonsense, all kinds of people will be coming your way and you'll just be tossing, going to and fro like a like a ball. So ladies, you know, have the right standards, okay, and stick to your standards. Not because desperation has entered now, just because, oh, I need a boo. You understand? Don't lower your standards. Now, you have to be realistic at the same time. Don't go and set too high standards that no man on earth can meet. Okay, God's not going to manufacture the husband for you and bring it. It's still a human being working on earth that is going to bring your way. So make your standards realistic, but they should be good. So yeah, and about standards, okay, there was something that someone told me there when I was in university, and it was so funny to me, but it is so true, okay? If you don't want to fall in love with an ugly person, do not hang around ugly people. That is just the truth. Because if you hang around ugly people long enough, that their ugliness will turn to beauty and you end up with an ugly person. It's funny, but it's true. So if you know you want to get yourself a good man, hang around the right crowd, okay? Like I read somewhere, I think I read this somewhere or someone said it to me. The person said, do not marry for money, okay? But go to where rich people are and marry for love. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Go to where good men are and marry for love. Don't be hanging around bad boys. Because sometimes some people say, oh, I want a good man. But ask yourself, do I really want a good man? Why am I hanging around, you know, assholes? I'm sorry, but why are you hanging around bad boys if you want a good man? Why? Are you planning to change him? Why are you planning to change a bad man when you can easily get a good man? And some of you say, oh, I want a good man. But when the good man comes, you maltreat him, you know? And that's my last point. Be nice. When a good man comes, you treat him anyhow. You see him like a loser. You have to have the eyes of the spirits. Yes, you have to have a discerning spirit. The eyes. Your eyes. You should be able to tell that. You should be able to see potential. Let me put it that way. Yes. You should be able to see potential. So when a good man comes your way, just because he doesn't dress the way you want, he doesn't look, trust me, a lot of good guys don't dress and look the way you know you want. It's the bad guys that are more interested in their looks. A lot of good guys out there are just clueless. They are clueless on how to dress, on how to, you know, look to attract the opposite sex. They're just there being good guys and facing their work, doing their work, trying to make money, you know, trying to make something of themselves. That's what they are concerned about. So they might not really look the way you want them to look. It is the bad guys that will be all buff and all dressed up and all this and all that, and we know the slick things to say. Mama was not really a slick talker at all. In fact, if I had chosen based on toasting, like her ability to toast, I won't even go my husband at all. Cha 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 cha. Because he was just there. But you see, those bad boys, they know what to say, they know how to sweep you off your feet, they know what to say to melt your heart. They know how to send you very lovely chats, they know how to call you in the middle of the night and lower their voice and be talking. They know how to, you know, make the butterflies in your tummy start dancing. Trust me, you better be wary of some of those kind of guys, because many of them are not good guys. Well, yeah, but there's some good guys that actually know how to dress, know how to talk to a woman and all that. I'm not saying that every good guy doesn't know how to talk to a woman and every bad guy knows how to. I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying, you know, you guys understand me now. Let me not be talking too much. You understand what I'm trying to say? A lot of times, the good guys do not come in the packages that we expect. So what did I say? Be nice to everybody. You don't know who will turn out to be your guy. Like, if, imagining if when my husband told me he wanted to marry me, and trust me, my husband told me he wanted to marry me shortly after we met. Like, when I say shortly, I mean, I think it was a matter of weeks or something. They told me I wanted to marry me. Was it weeks or how many days? Okay, we had talked on the phone before we met physically. So I think after we met physically, 2 days after, he told me he was going to marry me. So when he said he wanted to marry me, I was like, okay, yeah, I hear you, bro. I hear you, brah. Anyway, but yeah, so I was still nice to him, okay? Some of you, the way you break up with your exes, or the way you break up with guys, or the way you turn down guys, is so nasty that you burn the bridge, you carry the ashes, go to the river and pour it, and then carry breeze and sweep that. I carry breeze and blow that river away, so that there will be no chance of you going back to that person. It's not good, okay? When somebody comes to meet you and is asking you out, or is asking you for a number, or tells you that he likes you, you know, don't turn him down. Even if it's not, you know, what you want. Even if it's not what you want, I know that no, I can never end up with this person. Do not turn him down in a very disrespectful or a very, don't go and start putting him on blast. Some people, a guy enters your DM, you come on internet and put him on blast. First of all, you are telling the whole world that nobody should even enter your DM in the first place, because if they say the wrong thing, there are chances of them ending up on your page is high. So why would they come and DM me in the first place? Anyway, but when a guy DMs you, even if you don't like who he is or what he's saying, just be nice about it, okay? Be firm but nice. I'm not saying you should be a walkover or you should be very flirtatious. I am just saying be nice but be firm. So you can say, no, I'm not ready for a relationship right now, but thank you so much for asking. Like, for someone that you feel is a nice person, though. I'm not talking about rude guys now, okay? Anyway, why am I even explaining too much? We're all adults here. So if you're not an adult here, you better walk away. But if we're all adults here, so you guys know what I mean, okay? When you see someone who is not someone you want to end up with, but is an okay person, just be nice to the person. It might not even be for you, you might not end up with him in relationship, but you might end up as good friends and opportunities can come from him in the future. Even if opportunities don't come, he's just one good person in your corner, finish, okay? It doesn't have to be what you gain from the person, it's just one more good person in the world that I can talk to, finish, okay? So yeah, it might not even be him, it might even be his brother that you end up with, it might be his friend, it might be his cousin, it might be his relative that he'll hook you up with. So at the end of the day, all I'm trying to say is just be nice. So yeah guys, that's the end of this video. What do you guys think? Is there any point that I missed out? How did you get yourself a good man, if you're married to a good man or if you're dating one? Or how do you think we can get ourselves good men this 2020? Okay, many of us are trying to, you know, start a family very soon. So leave in the comment section. I want all of you that are married and all of you that are in good relationships to leave in the comment section things that you did that you feel got you a good man, or advice if you're a person that you've been attracting bad men and you now know you've seen the light and you now know the right thing to do. Tell us the things that you were doing wrong before that you feel people should not do so that they can land themselves good men in 2020. Okay, yeah, so yeah, that's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I actually enjoyed it myself. If you guys enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, please. Yeah, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.